to present a topic on in vitro evaluation antimicrobial activity of calendula. Department of Pathology and Microbiology. A very good afternoon to all the dignitaries whoever are there on the dais. I'm going to present a project which we have proposed in JIMS. It is an, a total in vitro project. So it is a project which is totally testing the homeopathic drugs on different microorganisms. So this is analysis of antibacterial activity of homeopathic drugs in vitro in urine samples of patients suffering from diabetes mellitus with asymptomatic UTI. As I am there in the lab, so we have observed a lot many UTI patients. So mostly they are all diabetic patients. So all are coming with an asymptomatic bacteriuria. So everyone are both on antibiotics as well as homeopathic drugs. So I have got an idea, why don't we test on this a small project. Just we have started it with a lab process. I have given a small project to my students. They have done well with calendula. She's also going to present that. After that, we have started with the help of Rita ma'am, Paul sir, and Navin sir. Just we have proposed a project and we have done a small preliminary work also. So as we all know, this is an introduction. Everyone here knows about the UTI, that is urinary tract infection, which is very common in diabetic patients, mainly diabetic mellitus type 2. So we have chosen those people whoever are coming, but everyone will complain about that urine, doesn't complain about urine infection, which is considered as an asymptomatic bacteria. So we want to work on that. So just we have tried in a different level. So when we have gone through all the reports of the lab, we found five different organisms which were very prevalent towards the JIMS. I mean, in Muchintal area, wherever this Shamshabad area. Right, right, sir. So E. coli, Enterobacteriaceae, Klebsiella, Proteus, Enterobacter, and Enterococci were the predominant organisms which we saw. So as we have seen that midstream urine is collected and it is considered as a positive one whenever it is cultured and it consists of more than 10 to the power of 5 microorganisms. So we have taken and the sample collection method, everything. And next, as I have studied, I am a non-homeopath even though I have an a lot much of interest towards homeopathy. So I have seen a lot many patients who were on these drugs mainly based upon their constitution, their modalities, those all things. So Cantharis, Staphylococcus, Pulsatilla, Mercor, and Sepia. So these are the common drugs which I have chosen for this study. And we want to test not only the homeopathic drugs, even different potencies. So everyone will be saying, there are a lot many controversies saying that potency drugs which are there, higher potency doesn't have any molecules and a lower potency is the one which will have. So I want to see whether this is going to be there, or else even a higher potency is going to work out as an antimicrobial active or not. So we have chosen all four potencies, and as a control, so ethanol has been chosen, 95% ethanol has been chosen for the control to test whether this is going to happen, because ethanol itself works as an antimicrobial agent. So these are the objectives. So just I'm giving a brief description. So this is a preliminary statistics which we have taken. So most of the controls who are there with only diabetes and those all things, we have taken out cases and controls. So patients who are having more UTI comparative, that means whoever are affected by diabetes having more urinary tract infections comparative the controls. So next, a simple test has been introduced where we can easily find out the presence of organism, that is a bacterial infection, that is nitrite test, which can be performed with a 10 rupee strip. So we have taken that, and the person who is not complaining about any bacterial infection and those all things, just we have used that strip. So if ever it is giving, there will be all the things, glucose, albumin, everything will be there. In that, nitrite is one. So if ever nitrite positive has come, we can say that the person is affected by some bacterial infection. We can't say which bacteria, but we can say that he is having some infection. So that test has been used, we have tested. So urine is collected and that strip test is done. So these are all the strips I made with the patients. So that is the nitrite test, which is positive. Next, we have even found out the organisms under the microscope, that is CUE. So in that also bacteria has been identified, such a sample has been selected and it is given for the culture. So we got a nice organisms on a specialized media known as Meconcis agar. So it has been said that the organism is E. coli. So first I have chosen E. coli because it is more prevalent compared to other organisms. So these are the homeopathic drugs which we have got from a good known company, and I have made an aliquots of those into a sterile vials. Next, to test their sensitivity, just we have followed a Kirby-Bars method, which is an antibiotic sensitivity method. So for that purpose, we don't have that antibiotic disc. So we only made a Watsman filter paper strips, whatever that disc, and those discs are used for the dispense of the medicine. So those discs and kept it. Here you can see that we are going to keep the disc in the on the medium. So next, this is kept, and the aliquots of different potencies of medicine is going to be dispensed, and we have kept it for the incubation. So as we have seen, that control whichever is there, that is going to give, the antimicrobial sensitivity. Whatever the space is there, that is non-growth. I mean, there is no growth, and it is known as zone of inhibition. So it has been found same as a control, and more than the control in so many samples. So this states that even more than 630 and 200, 1 mm is working more compared to others. So this we have tried with all the things. Here you can see with all different cantharis, murkwas, staphylococcus agria, pulsatilla, where these are the zone of inhibitions. These are the zone of inhibitions without culture, which says that there is no growth of bacteria. So this concludes that the organisms are affected by these drugs as usual, and this can be used, that means for an antibiotic, easily microorganisms will get their resistance towards antibiotics, and we have to go for the changing of generations of antibiotics. That can be, vanished if ever we are going to support RLs, if we are going to prove that homeopathic drugs are going to play a main role. So this is the inhibition zones, zone of inhibitions. Here you can see that pulsatilla and cantharis are showing in 1 mm more than the controls, that is 95% ethanol, which states that this is the graph which we have drawn. So this is cantharis, yellow one is the 1 mm. So 1 mm has got more antimicrobial activity compared to this. This is a small preliminary study we have performed on the E. coli, which has been seen, and even this can be afterwards can be concluded or else included in a thing like a relative remedy studies. This will be told by Sir Navin Sir, because it can be even application can be done in the homeopathy, saying that one constitutional medicine, if ever it is positive towards any organism, if it's another medicines will be there, whatever the sub medicines can be used, and it is considered. I don't have that much concept knowledge of it. One Navin sir can explain. So that relative remedy concept is going to be placed over in a homeopathy if ever it is going to be proved, and this will be very useful to the clinicians if ever it is done. And next, this work, a small bit of work has been sent, abstract has been sent to an international conference where it has been accepted as a, for a oral presentation. It is for an antimicrobial congress, 2019. A small preliminary work which we have done, but much more has to be performed because we have an, we have to do it on more than 50 patients, and we have to find out. It has to be concluded, and the same result should be obtained from all the patients and all different organisms. If it is going to come positive for this, definitely homeopathy with a one-m potency is having a more. We can say that yes, it can work out. So we have any plans to work with its dynamic force, and we even want to work on a nanoparticles. Nanoparticles, if ever they are present in 1M, and what is the concentration, those all things, just we are trying out to do it. This is a small piece of work which we have performed in JIMS. Thank you.
Dr. Madhavi. Now, may I call upon our third year student, B. Pujita, to kindly come over and present a topic. The topic is in vitro evaluation of antimicrobial activity of calendula.
Good afternoon to all the dignitaries present in the dais. Myself, I am B. Pujita from 3rd year HMS. In 2nd year, out of our interest, we had performed a small lab experiment on calendula to see its effectiveness and uniqueness, how calendula works as a homeopathic dynamic antiseptic. We know that homeopathy la is similia similibus curantur, that is like cures like. Homeopathic drug having action similar to the pathogenic effect of microorganism is similibiotic. The present study shows the in vitro antibacterial activity of homeopathic drug or remedy. The concept and even the attempt to use substances derived from one organism to kill the another organisms are almost old as the science of bacteriology. Firstly, objectives to do an experiment is to know the effectiveness and action of calendula. So we have used calendula in potencies like 6C, 30C and 1M potency. So source of bacteria is the bacteria isolated from the injury which come from the drug susceptibility test of allopathic medicines, that is known as antibiotics. Culture of bacteria, the bacteria are cultured by streak culture. Identification of bacteria, they are identified by colony characteristics, staining and by the biochemical test. Examining the action of homeopathic drug on bacteria using appropriate media, method and material which are recognized in modern medicine. The evaluation of the results by the reaction on drug on bacteria. So, we had took a perspire for inoculating the bacteria, and then the perspire was inoculated onto the nutrient agar medium. After 24 hours of incubation, the growth is obtained by staphylococcus. And then we had prepared filter dist 5mm of Fortman's filter paper, placing the filter paper in the agar medium, and then dispensing the calendula mother tincture with different potencies like 6C, 30C and 1M. And then after 24 hours of incubation again, the growth was obtained with zone of inhibition in 1M potency. There we can see. So, conclusion is what? It is evident that homeopathic drugs action, homeopathic drugs has action on the bacteria. This may represent the indirect stimulatory action on host. So homeopathic drugs can play an instrumental role by not making the bacterial resist, the bacterial strain resistant, at the same time ensuring to mutation, thus preventing the society from hazardous new forms. Hence I conclude that homeopathic drugs, every homeopathic drug can act on microorganisms, bacteria and all that. So I can, thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Pujita. Now, may I call upon Dr. Pravas Pal, HOD, professor in the Department of Pharmacy, JIMS.
From Calcutta. I am also from Calcutta. So I quote a word of Swami Vivekananda. This is more for you, especially as students. Don't accept anything before you get its evidence. You must get evidence, you must have convictions to accept anything. So here, this project, this drug proving is something which augurs you to get the evidence and then accept your system. This is for you, this project for you. See that how this drug proving project has gone here in these institutions and how your students, you students have taken part and did this work. This was done last year. Here Dr. Kurana is here, sitting here, and sir came along with Dr. Pita Behra in the month of May last year to begin this project, this drug grooming project, and then we all joined together. This project started 2017-18 in association with CCRH. This homeopathic pathogenetic trial, you know that I need not explain it. This is the basic foundations of homeopathy, and this is in fact drug proving paves the way for the homeopathy. Without drug proving, homeopathy cannot exist. So this is, I can say that this drug proving is a moral obligation for all of us to take up, to think over this and to join hands with the drug proving. So this, with the coded medicine from CCRH, this proving started with the aims of this formulations of proving results by recording data in symptom elaboration sheets and to confirm the previous observations. Proving was done with two quotas of the drug finally it was coded, decoded that justicia in that order 30 potency. There are two quotas. First intervention, see that how the students were subjected to this drug and what symptoms they produced and what pains they went through. There are some, unless you have the pains, you can't gain. So there are some pains they had to go through, and they finally appreciated. We all appreciate, we compliment to them for their venture, and they also came and appreciated. So give a round of applause for all of them. Yes. They have volunteered, not that somebody was insisted, they volunteered themselves. Actually, initially there was, when we announced that there will be drug proving program, in fact there was a knee-jerk reactions from students initially. So around 50 students came, took part, then they screened out, and finally it dropped out down to 20. 20 students at last, they started this work. So out of the 20 provers, 18 provers produced symptoms and one of them dropped out. Different reasons dropped out. One prover, all 18 provers produced many symptoms, but one of them produced backache. And when they found that, we consulted CCRH officials, and when they said that you go for an USG, and we found that there is a renal calculi. This is the first intervention. There are many other things. I just have a glimpse here. Second intervention, see that 10 provers out of 19, one dropped out. 19 provers produced symptoms out of 19, 10. Those, all these compilations were sent to CCRH. Everything was done, and this proving prover project is already over. Now, see that USG reports showed that apart from other, many other physical and mental symptoms, see that these are the proof I am telling. This is the proof what homeopathic medicines can do, how powerful they are. See that this is the proof, living proof in front of you. See that this renal calculi from 13 provers were found. Ovarian cyst with thickened endometrium in 4 provers. And mild hydronephrosis is 1 prover were found. 6 of the 13 provers who produced renal calculi on USG were otherwise asymptomatic. They did not have any symptom. Only this was found in the USG during the second quota of proving. And one of the 6 asymptomatic provers did not produce any symptom both in first intervention and second interventions. None of the, no symptom produced, only except the renal calculi. 2 of the provers who produced renal calculi were non-hostilites, and others are also hostilites. During the event of drug proving, that time when drug proving was going on, 3 of the provers who produced renal calculi also produced ovarian cysts. So multiple clinical conditions they produced. 3 provers showed increased level of TSH. That is also something interesting. No abnormality detected in other investigations. Do you believe now homeopathy?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
It is very minimum. It's not louder.
Yes.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. This is something. So need not get the more convincing proof than this. Yes. So this is, with this, now students have got more encouragement, and they have come to take part the second project in the larger numbers. Now, second project is going to start this 2018-19, this year. Again, CCRH has given us a project. We really thank CCRH authorities for giving us this project. These materials will be the existence of a written protocol we will follow. Last time also we did that CCRH protocol. Data collection will be done in day book format, and study design will be double blind, placebo control, randomized parallel study. Source of data, the homeopathic medicines, the coded medicine work CCRH will be sending. Soon they will be sending the placebo. And now from the 60 provers, we have screened out, and finally 24 of them got opportunity to take part in this. Not that everyone, whoever comes, this is the after stringent screening, then these 24 of them got the chance as a healthy volunteers. They will be going same for PA, pre-medical examinations. The consent will be signed by the volunteers who are eligible as per this format, and during timeline will be the 1 week pre-trial period, then 1 month verum and placebo period control, and then 1 week post-trial observation period. This medication will be administered 4 times in a day, four globules every time. And this time, proving will be done mostly on 3 quotas, because even CCRH authority has been very much appreciating, and they are also encouraged to go with us, and they said this time you do the 3 quotas, and this has come to the CCRH bulletin. Even it is given that same time, this is a multicentric trial. In the same time, other centers also they given the drugs. JIMS Homeopathic Medical College is the first center where they came out with all the results and data. And within record time, just within 6 months, they completed the entire data processing and proving. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Pramaspal. Now, I would humbly request Dr. Rita Krishnan to come on the dais and present a topic. Ma'am is speaking on a comparison of conventional and homeopathic paradigms in treating children aged 0 to 18 months, a pragmatic randomized clinical trial.
JIMS is the only hospital which has been awarded this project. We are doing a comparative study of 100 neonates. It's basically putting the children, one group on conventional medicine and the other group on homeopathic medicines. It's a pragmatic randomized clinical trial. So it's in collaboration with CCRH, CICM, Israel, and JIMS Hospital. The principal investigator is Dr. Raj Manchanda. We have program official Dr. Anil Khurana, medical monitor Dr. Menachem Oberbaum from the JIMS Hospital, and the site investigator, and we have Dr. R.M. Pandey as a biostatistician. The program protocol development and data coordination will be done from headquarters of CCRH, and Dr. Anupriya and Dr. Divya Taneja would be helping us on that. So basic difference, what generally in conventional medicine you do a randomized control trial where you have one remedy given for one disease and you get one effect. Whereas in with homeopathy, you know that the drug is able to give multiple effects on a particular patient. So that's why we have designed a pragmatic trial where we give the remedy, X remedy for X, Y number of illness, and you get Z number of response. The primary objective here is to compare the health status of the children treated through homeopathy and treated through conventional medicine. The children, the age group that we are considering is neonate, newborns to 18 months of age. So we'll be enrolling the child at birth and then following up the child for 1.5 years. The secondary objective is to see the overall growth and development of the children. What is the economic burden on the system for both homeopathy as well as the allopathic medicines? What are the number of diarrheal episodes that the children suffer from, which will be compared in both the groups, the number of respiratory illnesses as well as the mortality rate in each group? The outcome, how do we measure the outcome, how do we assess what are the things? We would be actually identifying the total number of sick days. So how do you know what are sick days? We are taking for infective illnesses or for febrile illnesses, any child which has an illness which has temperature of more than 37.5. And for non-infective, the treating doctor, if they diagnose it as an acute episode, we take that as an acute illness. And for secondary, the outcome measures, we do the infant behavior questionnaire. We check the baby's height, weight, overall milestones, mid upper arm circumstances and circumference and head circumference. And the comparing the sum of diarrheal days and the sum of ill days in respiratory infections and the mortality rate. We would also try to, we will also keep a track on the cost that has been incurred in treating these children, both in both the groups. Even if the children, suppose they are not able to come here and they take any treatment outside, we would keep a track on how much they spend on the consultation, on the investigations and the medicines. The inclusion criteria, we are taking male or female children who is single born. Twin pregnancy is excluded. Children who are born to healthy mothers who has undergone an institutional delivery in the hospital, in our hospital itself, and who has a gestational age of 37 to 42 weeks. So that means the premature children are not included. We take the informed consent of both the parents. And we also try to see if the parents are residing within 60 kilometers from the hospital. So we try to motivate the parents, or we insist that the parents should be coming to the hospital for any illness. But we, because of some reason, if it is at night, we are at a distance that the hospital can send the vehicle and evaluate the child. So that's the reason we have to consider the area of around 60 kilometers around the hospital. Exclusion criteria, any congenital infections, congenital malformations, or the mothers who are HIV infected or hepatitis B or C infected. So these three factors, we have kept it as an exclusion criteria. So overall, at birth, we will enroll the children, take the consent of the parents. Once the parent give the consent, we will then randomly distribute the children in these two groups of conventional and homeopathic medicines. These children will be observed for 18 months. We expect the children to give a follow-up every 3 months. In between every month, the research officers will be calling up to make sure that the child is doing fine. And this entire study will be analyzed and then evaluated for the results. The enrollment has been told. All the children in the conventional medicine group will receive only allopathic medicines. In homeopathic group, the children will primarily receive homeopathic treatment. In cases of life-threatening illnesses, the child might be treated with allopathic medicine. But the children will remain to continue in the homeopathic group. Randomization will be done. There is actually almost 120 sealed covers that we have. So as and when we are enrolling the students, we'll open the cover and see whether they would fall in which group. So that will reduce the bias that we will have. The parents are given the freedom to withdraw at any point of time. So there is no binding on them. We as our investigators can withdraw the child if we find any congenital anomaly at the later stage, or if the protocol is not strictly followed, we will have to withdraw the project. The analysis will be done based on intention to treat. What that means is, if a child drops off due to any reason, suppose, you know, after 8 months, 9 months, if the child drops off, we'll still continue the child in that group, and whatever the results have been obtained will be taken up for the analysis. So we will not replace the patient. Suppose we are enrolling 50 patients in one group, if one or two patient drops off, we will not replace the patients in that group. All the investigations, medicines, everything will be given free of cost to all the children in both the groups. And this is sponsored by CCRH. Any questions? So this is a study which will probably take around 2 years. So all the people who are involved in that, we have asked them to be with us in the organization for minimum 2 years. Once the study is analyzed, we can take it forward. This is a pilot project basically. So we can, depending on the result, we can take it at a higher level.
Thank you, Dr. Rita. Now, I invite all the dignitaries to please come onto the dais. May I call upon Dr. Rita and Dr. Naveen Pavaskar sir and Dr. Raghuram Chandra to kindly escort the dignitaries onto the dais. Shri Swamiji, Dr. Rameshwar Rao, Dr. Anil Kurana, Padma Shri Dr. Professor V.K. Gupta, Dr. M. Abraham, Dr. Krishna Paul Chaudhary, Dr. Venu Gopalchari, Dr. N.S. Prashant, Dr. Arvind Koti. May I call upon Dr. Hema Bindu and Dr. Anupriya to kindly come onto the stage. Now, may I call upon Swamiji to give the floral bouquet to Dr. Oberon, Dr. Rameshwar Rao to give a floral bouquet to Dr. Anil Kurana, Dr. Krishna Chaudhary sir to give floral bouquet to Dr. V.K. Gupta, Dr. Rameshwar Rao, sir, to give the floral bouquet to Dr. Anil Kurana.
Second time. Dr. Krishna Chaudhary, sir, to give third bouquet to Dr. V.K. Gupta.
It is come. Pleasure. Enjoy, happy Janata.
Dr. Rita Krishna, to give total bouquet to Dr. Anupriya.
Come. Is it continued? Continued, okay.
Dr. Abraham Chandra, sir, to give the floral bouquet to Dr. Venam Gopalchari, sir.
This
hamper consists of the soap which have been made in our own distribution in the pharmacy department.
Indigenous.
again. Now we will be having a session for the distribution of institutional ethical certificates to the investigators. I request Dr. Brown to present the certificate to Dr. Jeeyar, Medical Superintendent, Homoeopathic Medical College and Hospital.
Swamiji, that our college is progressing so fast that we have not passed out first batch, but we have taken two research studies here. So I think this is the enthusiasm of the faculty and the support of the whole trust and Swamiji, that we are progressing in a such a manner that it's not far off that very soon you will get PG here also. Actually, research is not an easy job. We need a strong aptitude to undertake research. Without aptitude of research, the quality cannot be taken up. Quantitatively, we may be doing a lot of projects, but quality only comes up with a strong aptitude for research. And for that purpose, we need to understand what are the basics of research. And it's very good that we have started taking up these kind of small studies, as we had clips of these presentations on antimicrobial studies and then small on drug proving also. My small suggestion for antimicrobial study would be to, when we take samples from the patients, I think doctor, you are doing that. Yeah. If you are taking samples, first ask homeopathic doctor to identify the remedy for that patient. What is the closest remedies, which are 2 or 3, then try those for anticoncept. So that medicine can be, whether that medicine helps that patient in that manner or not. So that will be the proper research study for homeopathic antimicrobial kind of a study. And simultaneously, we should also try to focus on drug resistant strains, whether homeopathy can help, because of rampant use of antibiotics, the drug resistance is coming up. Most of the bacterial strains, they are becoming drug resistant. And if we can give an alternative to antibiotics, that homeopathic medicines can work even in those drug resistant strains, that will be a great contribution from homeopathic side. We have already started this kind of a project in our CCRH, and we are going to come up with some kind of these kind of results. And it's very fascinating and quite encouraging from this college with such a good infrastructure. When first time I came to this institute, this college, when we started drug proving center here, the kind of enthusiasm which I saw here, I recommended my DG to study, take up this kind of a study with Israel here only. Although we had visited many other hospitals, we visited with Dr. Obermann at two or three centers more. But we could find out that feasibility is here when we take up these kind of studies. And I wish all the success, because I am a part of that particular study. We are supporting from CCRH all the way. And we want this study to be taken up successfully, whatever the outcome, but we have to work according to the protocol which we have designed. And we hope to get better results with homeopathic medicine, because for children, homeopathic medicines have always been found fruitful. Very encouraging results we have already seen. I just shared one small, which I shared in the meeting today in the morning. We had taken up a project on homeopathy for a healthy child with the inspiration from Honorable Prime Minister. He once in a meeting just said, why don't you prescribe calcarea phos to the children, which all other are recommending? What stops you? So we started before recommending that for a public health, why not to take up a pilot study? And we initiated that pilot study in 6 districts, 12 blocks. And we started enrolling since 2015. This year in March 2018, we have completed that first leg of that particular study. Almost 70,000 children from 6 months to 3 years of age, we have enrolled under those districts. And we started analyzing the results, because we wanted to give it to the government, what has been the outcome of that when we prescribed calcarea phos. We developed a small kit of ASHAs for ASHAs. ASHAs are accredited social health activists, you know about this. They are first contact with the patients, with the families. For every 1,000 family members, there's one ASHA deputed at the health infrastructure. So we provided a kit which contains only 6 medicines, and one was calcarea phos, which has to be given from 6 months to 1 year of age to every children which are enrolled into that. And we wanted to see what is the outcome of that particular usage of that calcarea phos, how it helps in their dentition pattern, how does other indicated medicine, because this kit medicine also had chamomilla, podophyllum, melodona, macphos and phalamphos. These were to address small problems these children suffer from, diarrhea, fever, upper respiratory tract infections, so up to 3 years. And now we have analyzed the data of 11,000 children who have completed 1 year follow-up under that particular study. And our results are so promising that there was not a single mortality in 70,000 children. That was the first observation. Not a single child died of diarrhea, upper respiratory infection, though these are the most common cause of mortality in India. And second aspect was that none of them was, say, only 7% means 93% responded to homeopathic medicine. They were not required to be referred to any other treatment. Only 7% required some kind of a referral, means in a general population this kit is can be used so that you can reduce the morbidity as well as the mortality. So that kind of a trial we have taken up, and about we have also analyzed how many children had delayed dentition, and we found that almost around 1,000 children were having delayed dentition. There was few exceptions with no teeth at 3 years, you can imagine. And we started calcarea foss, and within 1 month all of those children developed their children teeth. This is the benefit of homeopathy in children. So it's a well accepted, no side effects, zero toxic effects, and that kind of a study. And this study, I'm very hopeful, from 0 to 18 months, as Dr. Deeta has presented that protocol here, we are going to get a very encouraging response, so that we can translate into a multicentric study later on and tell to the government and the policy makers, other stakeholders, use homeopathy for children. That will help them in a long run. Thank you so much.
Valuable and inspiring speech. That simple calcarea for, it's not simple, calcarea for 6x and so minute doses have improved a lot.
Practical.
Yeah, it's practically, and we generally talk about calcarea first that is useful for dentition. So may I request Padma Shri Dr. Professor V.K. Gupta, Chairman Scientific Advisory Committee, CCRH, Government of India, Ministry of Ayush.
Peculiar, uncommon, rare, strain. Common has no value. Common man has no value. I find this institution to be peculiar, uncommon, rare, and strain in many
respects.
It is only because the rare, peculiar, uncommon, you are able to individualize. And that is how I am able to individualize this institution from the entire country. I have never seen such a good institution in my life. This is another person. So, it is uncommon, rare, strange. In this sense, it provides world quality of healthcare and keeping the pocket of the poor man into consideration. So, high quality treatment with affordable cost. It is very rare, and you need not advertise. People will come to you. It will like honeybee. People will come to you because good quality and cost effectiveness. What else you want? And above all, homeopathy is also cost effective. So that way. And another good thing I saw, the enthusiasm among the students to do drug brewing.
Actually, you study drug brewing, you read drug brewing, you memorize drug, but you have, in order to be very close to the Mathematica, you must feel Mathematica. It is only those who have done the movie, they have felt Mathematica, and that remains in the whole life. So feeling of Mathematica is the most important thing. I know many homeopaths who have no confidence whether what 200 will do. If they have no confidence what 200 will do, how will they be a leader in homeopathy? How can they motivate young students about the efficacy of homeopathy? Please understand. So everybody must feel, do drug brewing and feel Mathematica. And I'm just reminded of, I was a teacher of Mathematica, I'm not a salesman, but you know, all subjects are important. But it is said that remove materia medica from the scene, homeopathy vanishes. With all respect to all the subjects, remove materia medica from the scene, homeopathy vanishes. So I'm just reminded of, because seeing the scientific aptitude and the potentiality of this institute, because it's an integrated institute. So seeing that potential, I like to remind all the senior people, because junior will not know, all the senior people, please go back to your Bodic Materia Medica, read the preface of Bodic Materia Medica, where Bodic himself, William Bodic himself wrote, as back as 1929, in a preface, that as at 1929 he wrote in America, that with the advanced knowledge of physiology and pathology, you will be able to explain the symptoms. Now, we have so much advanced knowledge of physiology and pathology, and we have all resources in Hyderabad, we can do a real study where we can, whenever any drug is given, a stimulus goes to the brain. And how those symptoms are produced, functional symptoms are produced, we are able to explain. Once we are able to explain the symptoms, what symptoms are occurring because of the, it will become more scientific. Everybody says, we are able to show biological effect, everything is fine, but how it is happening, nobody is able to show. If you are able to explain in their terminology, if I am an Indian, if I have to talk to a German man, I will talk in Hindi, he will not understand. So it is very essential that we have to speak in the language which the scientific world understands. So this is very important area. Please don't take it lightly. You must collaborate, because Hyderabad is a place where you have got all sorts of people around. If you can do this, what William Bodic left at that time, he said pathology knowledge, physiology knowledge is not advanced at that time. Now it is advanced. It's 2018. So if we do that, reverse pharmacology, I like to tell you, even belladonna. Say belladonna. Belladonna is sympathetic and parasympathetic. So it depresses the parasympathetic component and it stimulates the sympathetic component. The once the sympathetic component is stimulated, the mouth becomes dry, the thirstless sense is there, absence of thirst is there, people get dilated, palpitation is there, heat of the upper part occurs, headache becomes worse by forward bending. So all, they can all be explained. So we have to rewrite, we cannot change the drugs, we cannot change the proving, but we have to give explanation. Homeopathy is descriptive science. Please, we have to make it as explanatory science. If we can explain symptoms which our fellow colleagues or other discipline can understand, it will be acceptable. People have been talking, you know, even Luc Montagnier, who is a Nobel laureate, he has showed that even there is no substance which is detectable, is able to, the starting material has substance and later on no detectable substance is there, still it is able to do biological effect. So there are indirect proofs. So we have to do so many things, and as we are progressing, opposition is also taking place. When we rise, opposition always takes place. Garib aadmi ka koi opposition nahi hota, ameer ka hi hota hai. Now we are getting taller, and so there is opposition is also taking place. And I have to tell you, the young doctor, they should feel very happy that they are in a very noble profession. And I just shared one latest study. In 2016, there was a study made by Indian Marketing Research Bureau. This study was done in 9 cosmopolitan cities of India. And they found 59% patients have shifted from allopathy to homeopathy. And those who were interviewed, they believe that 77% percent believe that homeopathy is the best form of treatment for long-term benefits, no relapses. And in Europe, the sale of homeopathy drug is $1 billion. And according to Ayush data, there is increase of sale of homeopathy medicine by 27.3% every year. So it is getting popular. So people are getting scared. Those lobbies are getting scared. They do not want to allow. So we have to do research. So only thing, as an individual person, I have made a lot of money. That's how I have also made a lot of money. We have also made a lot of name. But we have not reached to the public health. Our homeopathy became popular, became very popular world over. When the pandemic of cholera broke out in the year, I'm forgetting the year, so the disciples of Hahnemann wrote to Hahnemann that we are finding these types of symptoms, what remedy should be given. Out of his knowledge, vast knowledge, he suggested three remedies, veratrum album, camphor and cupremetallicum. And the response was so good. And those who received allopathic treatment, their death rate was much higher as compared to the persons who received homeopathic treatment. And when anything good happens, commission is appointed. Anything bad happens, commission is appointed. So the commission was appointed, and the commissioner of that commission wrote, if I suffer from cholera, I should be given homeopathy rather than allopathy. So my point is, when, and you see, homeopathy is being practiced in 86 countries in the world, in the absence of official recognition. It is because of the inbuilt merit. Somebody asked, is homeopathy scientific? Then he asked another question. Why are you asking this question? Then he asked, please let me know for how many years it is existing in the world? He said, 200 years. Then he said, why ask this question? If anything is existing for 200 years, why are you asking this question? It is a killer cut. Because of the merit, it has thrived. So, there's much to speak, but I think I'm taking a lot of time. Sorry for taking more time. With these words, I take my seat, and I feel that I'm the lucky person to come to this institution, and this is one of the best visits I have ever had. And I tell you, I'm proud to be homeopath. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your valuable speech. May I request to the lotus feet of Swamiji to grace this occasion and bless us.
At the outset, our kudos to all the students here. Because all of you are blessed with the experiences of senior most practitioners of homeopath from across the world. You are going to share their experiences. You are going to share their knowledge so that you can be the future for homeopath in bringing out the inner abilities of homeo and proof that world can survive with less cost of medicine, more self-power. So we offer Mangala Sasanams to you all and to all the dignitaries who are here from Israel, from Israel, and also from Delhi, and from different parts of the country. Ivela, mi andaritoti ee parishodhana karyakramalo palgodam aaku chaala santoshanga undi. Dr. Paulluri gar cheppinatluga homeopathy maniharamuga వెలుగొందడానికి ఏర్పడ్డ ఈ జిమ్స్ ఇవాళ నుంచి ఒక పరిశోధన కార్యక్రమాన్ని ఇక్కడ ఆరంభం చేస్తుంది. చిన్నపిల్లలుగా పుట్టినప్పటి నుంచి 18 నెలల లోపు ఉండేటటువంటి పిల్లలకి ఒక ఇతర వైద్య విధానాలు, ముఖ్యంగా అలోపతిక్ సిస్టమ్ ఎట్లా వాళ్ళని సాకుతుంది, హోమియోపతి ఎట్లా వాళ్ళని సాకుతుంది, ఈ రెండింటినీ కూడా పరిశీలన చేసి దేని వలన పిల్లలలో ఆ 18 నెలల ప్రాయానికి రోగాలు తక్కువగా ఆరోగ్యవంతంగా ఉండగలిగేటట్లుగా పిల్లలు తయారవుతారో దాని మీద ఒక వైజ్ఞానికమైనటువంటి పరిశోధన చేసే ఒక ప్రాజెక్టుని మన భారత ప్రభుత్వం ఇనిషియేట్ చేస్తే అది వీరితోటి మన ఇజ్రాయెల్ ప్రభుత్వంతో దానిని పైలట్ ప్రాజెక్టుగా మన జిమ్స్లో జరపడానికని నిర్ణయం ఉంది. అది ఈవేళ ఆరంభమవుతుంది. ముఖ్యంగా దీనిని మరికొంచెం ముందుకి తీసుకువెడుతూ ఇలాంటి పరిశోధనలు ముఖ్యంగా డెవలపింగ్ కంట్రీస్కి మన భారతదేశానికి ఎక్కువగా ఈ రోజుల్లో ఉండేటటువంటి గ్లోబలైజేషన్ దృష్ట్యా ఏర్పడేటటువంటి రకరకాల ఇబ్బందులను దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకుని తక్కువ ఖర్చుతోటి ఎక్కువ ఆరోగ్యాన్ని శ్రమ లేకుండా ఒక వ్యక్తికి ఇవ్వడానికి వీలయ్యే విధానంగా హోమియోపతిని నిరూపించడానికి ఇది ఇవరికే నిరూపణ జరిగి ఉన్నప్పటికీ దీని విషయంలో ఇంతవరకు సరైనటువంటి ప్రోత్సాహం మనకి లభించలేదు. అయినప్పటికీ ప్రజా ఆదరణ ఈ హోమియో విధానానికి చాలా ఉంది. దీనిని ఇప్పుడు మన ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ గారి యొక్క నేతృత్వంలో మన ప్రభుత్వం కూడా గుర్తించి దీనిని ప్రోత్సహించి దీనికి మరింత అవకాశం తనని నిరూపణ చేసుకోవడానికి వీలయ్యేటట్లుగా అవకాశం కలిగించాలి అనే అభిప్రాయంతో ఈ రీసెర్చ్ ప్రాజెక్ట్ ఆరంభమైంది. మన భారతదేశంలో మన జిమ్స్ కాలేజ్ అండ్ హాస్పిటల్ ఇవి రెండూ కూడా హోమియోపతి యొక్క విలువని గుర్తించి హోమియోపతి విలువకి అగ్రాసనం వేసి దానిలో ఉండేటటువంటి మంచిని సమాజానికి అందించే లక్ష్యంతో ఏర్పడ్డ సంస్థలు కావడం చేత దీంట్లో ఈ పరిశోధనను జరపాలి అని వారు నిర్ణయం చేసి ఇక్కడ దీన్ని తీసుకురావడం మాకు చాలా సంతోషంగా ఉంది. ముఖ్యంగా ఈ వరకే మన జిమ్స్ కాలేజ్ అలాగే జిమ్స్ హాస్పిటల్ ఇవి రెండు కూడా మీలాంటి మంచి విద్యార్థులు మీలాంటి కమిటెడ్ విద్యార్థుల వల్ల తన యొక్క సామర్థ్యాన్ని నిరూపించుకోగలిగినందుకు మాకు చాలా సంతోషంగా ఉంది. ఎందుకనంటే గత ఏడాదిలో మొత్తం మన తెలుగు రాష్ట్రాల్లో అంటే మన యూనివర్సిటీస్లో అటు ఎన్టీఆర్ యూనివర్సిటీ కానీ ఇటు కాళోజీ యూనివర్సిటీలో కానీ జరిగినటువంటి వార్షిక పరీక్షల్లో వచ్చినటువంటి సుమారు 92 ఏ ర్యాంకర్స్లో 56 ఏ ర్యాంకర్స్ మీలోంచి వచ్చారు. అంటే సుమారుగా 60% ఏ ర్యాంకర్స్గా మీరు మీకుండేటటువంటి హోమియోని మనం బాగా నేర్పాలి, అందులో ఉండేటువంటి అంత సారాన్ని గ్రహించాలి, దీన్ని అందరికీ అందించేటటువంటి ఒక మహాయజ్ఞంలో మనం అందరం కూడా భాగం కావాలి అనేటటువంటి ఒక సిన్సియర్ కమిట్మెంట్ మీ అందరిలో ఉండడమే దీనికి ప్రధానమైనటువంటి కారణం. ఆ మీ కమిట్మెంట్ని చూసే ఇప్పుడు ఈ పరిశోధన యాక్టివిటీ ఇప్పుడు ఇక్కడికి రావడం జరిగింది. ఇది త్వరలో మంచి ప్రయోజనాన్ని సమాజానికి మంచి ఆరోగ్యాన్ని సంరక్షించుకునే దృష్టితోటి అందిస్తుంది అని మేము విశ్వసిస్తున్నాం. ఇప్పుడే ఈ పరిశోధనని సాగించేటటువంటి ఈ పెద్దలకి ఒక చిన్న సూచన చేయడం జరిగింది. పుట్టినప్పటి నుంచి 18 నెలల దాకా సాగించేటటువంటి పరిశోధన ఒక ఎత్తు అయితే పుట్టడానికి ముందు నుంచి అంటే ఒక మహిళకి గర్భవతిగా డిక్లేర్ అయినప్పటి నుంచి ఆ లోపల పెరిగేటటువంటి శిశువుకి ఎక్కువ భాగం ఆర్గాన్స్ డెవలప్మెంట్ అంతా లోపలే జరుగుతుంది. బయటికి వచ్చిన తర్వాత డెవలప్ అయ్యే ఆర్గానిజం చాలా తక్కువ ఉంటుంది. అందుచేత లోపల ఆర్గాన్స్ ఎప్పుడు డెవలప్ అవ్వడం ప్రారంభిస్తాయో అప్పటి నుంచే ఒక విధానంలో వాడని పెంచి అటు అలోపాథిక్ సిస్టంలో కొందరిని
హోమియోపాథిక్ సిస్టంలో కొంతమందిని. ఇలాగా వాళ్ళని మనం వాళ్ళ వాళ్ళ గృహాల్లోనే అట్టే పెట్టి, కానీ ఎలాంటి ఆహార విహారాలు ఉండాలి, ఏ రకమైనటువంటి జాగ్రత్తలు తీసుకోవాలి, ఎమోషనల్గా ఆ తల్లులు ఎలా వాళ్ళు ప్రవర్తించినట్లయితే ఉల్లాసంగా వాళ్ళు ఉండగలుగుతారు, ఇలాంటివి వాళ్ళకి మినిమం గైడ్లైన్స్ మనం ఇచ్చి, ఏ సమస్య వారికి ఏర్పడ్డా దాన్ని జాగ్రత్తగా గమనించి వారిని మనం ఆ సమయంలో అంటే వాళ్ళకి ప్రెగ్నెన్సీ డిక్లేర్ అయినప్పటి నుంచి కూడా వాళ్ళని జాగ్రత్తగా గమనించి, పెరిగే వయసులో 18 మాసాలు వచ్చేటంత వరకు కూడా వాళ్ళని చూడడం లాంటి పరిశోధన జరిగినట్లయితే ఇంకా కొంచెం బాగుంటుంది అని ఒక చిన్న సలహా వారికి ఇవ్వడం జరిగింది. దాన్ని కూడా రేపు దీని తర్వాత జరగబోయే పరిశోధనల్లో వారు దాన్ని తీసుకుంటారు. మీరందరూ కూడా దాంట్లో భాగస్వామి కాబోతున్నాను. ఇది మీ అందరికీ చాలా అదృష్టం. ఎందుకంటే ఇప్పటిదాకా మన దేశంలో ఉండేటువంటి ఎన్నో హోమియో కాలేజెస్ ఉన్నప్పటికీ, ఇందాక మన గుప్తాజీ చెప్పినట్లుగా అతి తక్కువ టైంలో, ఖురానా గారు కూడా చెప్పారు, అతి తక్కువ టైంలో మంచి గుర్తింపు పొందడంతో పాటు ఇలాంటి ఒక అంతర్జాతీయ పరిశోధన జరిపేటటువంటి, వారితో కలిసి ఒక కొలాబరేషన్తో జరిపేటువంటి అవకాశం ఇంతవరకు ఎవరికి పోసే వచ్చినట్టు లేదు. దిస్ ఈజ్ ఏ గ్రేట్ బూన్ టు ఆల్ ద స్టూడెంట్స్ హూ ఆర్ ఇన్ ద జిమ్స్, బికాస్ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు బి ది రీసెర్చ్ స్కాలర్స్. You are going to prove the efficacy of homeo. You are going to present the scientific evidences to the world so that homeo works like this. So you can stress upon the importance and efficacy of homeo with your own experiments, with your own experiences, sharing better guidance from the great doctors who are having wonderful expertise in their own area, in their own countries. ఇక్కడ కూర్చున్నటువంటి వీరు ఇజ్రాయెల్లో వారు చెప్పారు, వారి యొక్క ప్రభుత్వం నడిపించేటటువంటి అతిపెద్ద హాస్పిటల్లో వారు హోమియో కన్సల్టెంట్గా ఉన్నారట. ఇందాక మేము వారితో మాట్లాడుతుంటే మాకు వారు చెప్పారు, వారి హాస్పిటల్లో మొట్టమొదటి హోమియోని అంగీకరించలేదట. చాలా శ్రమపడి కొద్దిగా వాళ్ళకి హోమియోని పరిచయం చేయవలసినటువంటి ఒక అవసరం ఏర్పడింది, బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ద డిసీజ్ దే హ్యావ్ ఇన్ దట్ టైం. చాలా చక్కటి రిజల్ట్ కనిపించడంతో క్రమంగా వారికి అవకాశం కలిగించి, ఇప్పుడు ఈవేళ ఈజ్ ఇన్ ఎ స్టేట్ వేర్ గవర్నమెంట్, వెన్ దే హ్యావ్ సమ్ క్రిటికల్ కేసెస్, దే కన్సల్ట్ దీస్ పీపుల్ ఫస్ట్, దెన్ దే స్టార్ట్ ట్రీట్మెంట్. So, I think you can imagine, if you are able to prove scientifically the efficacy of what you are in, government and the scholars and the society will be forced to adopt them. You are in a position to make that dream real with regard to homeopathy. Are you ready? How many of you? So that's great. Be ready now. Just start your journey of research so that you become the pioneers and pilots for future homeopath. God bless you all, and we pray to God to bless all this wonderful team who are going to make this research project more successful, and also make it as a maiden project for many more research projects to continue. Our prayers and also blessings to all of you, and also to the CCRH and also the research officers came from Delhi all the way to make this project take reality. God bless you all once again, and Jai Shri Narayana.
talk in public, the first thing that you learn is not to start with the word I. But in this case, I'll make an exception. A conventional physician heading a department in a conventional hospital and teaching in a conventional medical school. It is my second visit here, and I think that to make a good a medical system which teaches and works, you need actually three factors. You need the resources, you need the soul, and you need the good stuff. I see here two person, and the third person, really a good stuff. To build a house or a building like that, resources are enough, but to bring it into an activity and to make it to something really great, and again, I'm really objective because from my resource I belong to the quote enemies, unquote. But I think that this project, the gym, is really an excellent project which fulfills these three requirements and has really a great future. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Oboba. May I request Dr. N.S. Prashant, retired additional director, Department of Ayush, the then Andhra Pradesh, it was a common state, and now he is a chairperson of the Institutional Ethics Committee of the JIMS. May I request, sir?
Respected Swamiji, the dignitaries on that, and my dear friends, I'm very, very happy to be associated with this project. Matter of fact, it's a dream for me. I joined Homeopathic Medical College 1963, graduated in 1967. I have seen a lot of deficiencies in almost all the institutions, including my own institution where I have studied. Various institutions, they are there, the intentions are honorable. But when it comes to doing things and practically applying those things, whatever we have learned theoretically, week zero, we hardly had any research. For any kind of research that you need to do, you need money, men and material. All the three are required. So in government institutions, you have material, you have men. Not all of them, not necessarily efficient. But here, you find an institution. After 15 years of experience in this profession, I am very, very glad to be associated with this institution because it has all the three. Men, material and men part of it. So it goes a long way in establishing the efficacy of homeopathy once again. We are convinced beyond any reasonable doubt. For practicing so many years, we know that homeopathy works. But how does a common man know it? How do we convince people? This is what we need to do here. And I'm absolutely delighted to be associated with this institution. Thank you so much. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you, sir. May I request Dr. Paulur Krishna Chaudhary, sir, Chairman, Academic Council, JIMS Homeopathic Medical College and Hospital, to address this occasion.
Who is Swamiji? ఎందుకంటే పెద్దలకు సభకు ప్రత్యేకంగా నా నమస్కారాలు. హోమియో వైద్యాన్ని కనిపెట్టినటువంటి హానిమన్, హోమియో వైద్యాన్ని ఆవిష్కరించింది కూడాను ప్రయోగాత్మకంగా ప్రయోగాలు నిర్వహించి, అందువల్ల హోమియో వైద్యంలో ప్రయోగాలకి ప్రత్యేక ప్రయోజనం ఎంతో ఉంది. హానిమన్ ప్రతి నాలుగో రోజు నిద్రపోకుండా తన జీవితకాలంలో సుమారు 100 ఔషధాలను మనకు అందించాడు. ఆ తర్వాత మీరు చూస్తున్నారు ఎక్కువగా ఔషధాలు మనకి ఎక్కువ లభించలేదు. ఇప్పుడు ఆ రకమైనటువంటి ప్రయోగాలు ఇప్పుడు మీరు పుట్టుతూనే పండితులైపోతున్నారు. ఇది గుర్తు అంటే ఇది చాలా బాధ్యత మీ మీద ఉంది, గుర్తుపెట్టుకోండి. ఎందుకంటే మీరు విద్యార్థి దశలోనే ప్రయోగాలు చేసి ఆ ప్రయోగ ఫలితాలని ప్రపంచానికి వెలుగులోకి తీసుకురాబోతున్నారు. రామేశ్వరరావు గారు ఆశించినటువంటి ఏ ఫలితం అయితే ఉందో ఆ ఫలితం సంపూర్ణంగా ఈ ప్రయోగాలు ఇలాంటి గొప్ప 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 ప్రయోగాలతోటే ఇప్పుడు నేను ఎందుకుంటున్నానంటే ఈ మాట, హోమియోపతి ప్రత్యేకంగా ప్రయోగాత్మకమైనటువంటి శాస్త్రం. ప్రయోగాలు హోమియోపతితోటే స్టార్ట్ అయినాయి అంటే మీరు నమ్మండి. అంతకుముందు ప్రయోగాలు ఎవరు చేసి వైద్య ధర్మాలని మనం వెలువరించాల. వైద్య ధర్మాలను వెలువరించింది హోమియోపతి. ఎలా? ప్రయోగాత్మకంగా. అందువల్ల ఆ దాని మీ విద్యాభ్యాసం యొక్క సత్ఫలితాలు ఈ ప్రయోగాత్మక రుజువులతోటి మీరు బాగా ఉపయోగించుకుంటారని ఒకసారి ఈ పెద్దలంతా మిమ్మల్ని దీవించడానికి వచ్చారు. అది గుర్తించి మీ బాధ్యత మీరు నిర్వహించాలని నేను కూడాను ప్రత్యేకంగా కోరుతున్నాను. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
అండ్ ఆదరణీయ అనుప్రియాజీ ఫ్రమ్ సిసిఆర్ఎల్ అండ్ హిమబిందు రీసెర్చ్ ఆఫీసర్ అండ్ రెస్పెక్టెడ్ పావులూరి కృష్ణ చౌదరి గారు, మరి మాకు డాక్టర్ రామేశ్వరరావు గారికి కంబైన్డ్ గురువు అయిన డాక్టర్ ఎన్ఎస్ ప్రశాంత్ గారికి, అదేవిధంగా పద్మశ్రీ అవార్డు ఇచ్చి ఆయన జీవితకాలంలో దేశంలో ఎందరో హోమియో ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్లకు ఇక్కడ కానీ బయట కానీ తిరిగి హోమియోలు అపారం ఉన్న గుప్త గారు, మరి నేను చూసే సర్వీస్ లోపల జేఎల్ స్వామి ట్రస్ట్ అధ్యయనం నడుస్తున్న జిమ్స్ కళాశాల నవ్వుతో నవ్వు భవిష్యత్తుగా 2 సంవత్సరాల పేరు తెచ్చుకొని చెప్పి స్వయంగా పేర్కోవటం మన అందరికీ ఈరోజు మరి తెలంగాణ ప్రభుత్వానికి కాకుండా భారతదేశానికి కూడా ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆదర్శంగా కాబోతున్నాయన్న వ్యాఖ్యలకు ఈరోజు మన కళాశాల ఆదర్శం అని చెప్పి సందర్భంగా తెలియజేస్తూ, మరి అందరం కూడా హోంపత్ చదివే ఒక స్థాయికి వచ్చాం. మరి మిత్రులు డాక్టర్ రామేశ్వరరావు గారు స్వామి గారి బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ తోటి అంటే మీరందరూ చూస్తుంటారు మీరందరూ కూడా ఫస్ట్ నీట్ రాశారు ఫస్ట్ టైంలో రాకుంటే సెకండ్ టైం క్వశ్చన్ ట్రై చేద్దామని వాళ్ళు ఇట్లా కళాశాల వచ్చారు కొందరు సెకండ్ టైం మాకు చెప్పకుండా రాసిండు అయినా రాలేదనుకోండి మళ్ళీ యూఆర్ కంటిన్యూయింగ్ ఫర్ థర్డ్ ఇయర్ నో దేర్ నో ఆప్షన్ ఫర్ యూ టు గో టు అదర్ సిస్టమ్ అయితే అటువంటి అవకాశం ఉన్నప్పటికి కూడా దాదాపు నాకు తెలిసినంతవరకు ఎందుకంటే నేను కూడా ఎంపీ అయిన తర్వాత పీజీ చేశాను ఎండి మెటీరియల్ మెడికా ఎందుకంటే చదివినప్పుడు నాకు కూడా తెలియదు హోమపతి ప్రాశస్తం గురించి తెలియదు ఏదో చదువు నాకు కూడా ఎంబీబీఎస్ మిస్ అయితేనే హోమపతికి వచ్చాను అప్పుడు నేను కూడా 4 సంవత్సరాలు చదవాలని చదివాము పాస్ అయ్యాము కానీ ఎప్పుడైతే ప్రాక్టీస్ స్టార్ట్ చేశామో అప్పుడు నిజంగా కూడా బై అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటింగ్ ద హోమపతి మెడిసిన్ ఐ ఫైండ్ రియల్ రిజల్ట్స్ కంపేర్ విత్ అలోపతి డాక్టర్స్ అలోపతి ప్రాక్టీస్ చేసుకుంటూ కూడా హోమపతి హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్ గ్యాప్ ఇచ్చి ఎక్సెప్ట్ స్టిరాయిడ్స్ యూజ్ టు ఉంటే పేషెంట్ యూస్ టు గెట్ రిజల్ట్ ఇమీడియట్ రిజల్ట్ 5 డే రిజల్ట్ యూస్ టు సీ విత్ ఇన్ 3 డేస్ అండ్ వన్స్ ఎపిడెమిక్ ప్రివైల్డ్ ఇన్ ద నిర్మల్ ఆదిలాబాద్ డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ వెరీ హై హెయిల్స్ ఐ కేమ్ ఫ్రమ్ నిర్మల్ కాన్స్టిట్యున్సీ నియర్లీ 3 టైమ్స్ గాట్ ఎలెక్టెడ్ దేర్ ఓన్లీ అయితే బిఫోర్ బికమింగ్ అ పొలిటీషియన్ ఎపిడెమిక్ ఇందాక చెప్పినట్టు జీ కేసులు ఎపిడెమిక్ అయినప్పుడు చాలా మార్టాలిటీ కేసెస్ వచ్చాయి చాలా కేసెస్ అందరి దగ్గర ఫెయిల్ అయిన కేసెస్ నా దగ్గరకు వచ్చాయి దాదాపు వచ్చిన కేసులలో ఎక్సెప్ట్ 1-2 కేసులు తప్ప అన్నీ సక్సెస్ అయినాయి దాంతో ఐ గాట్ గుడ్ రేంజ్ ఓన్లీ అప్పుడు హోంపతి వాడాను అల్లపతి వాళ్ళే బట్ సెలైన్ ఇచ్చుకుంటూ వెయిట్ చూసుకుంటూ దో ఐమ్ నాట్ ఎ పీడియాట్రిషియన్ కానీ పీడియాట్రిక్ కాకుండా కూడా వెయిట్ చూసుకుంటూ ఎసిడిటీ డెవలప్ కాకుండా గ్యాస్ట్రిక్ డెవలప్ కాకుండా వెయిట్ చూసుకుంటూ సెలైన్ ఇచ్చి ఓన్లీ ఇప్పు కాకుండా కానీ డిపెండ్ అపాన్ ద సిమ్టమ్స్ ఇచ్చుకుంటూ పోతే ఐ గాట్ గుడ్ రిజల్ట్ విత్ దట్ ఏంటంటే నాకే సిస్టమ్ మీద నమ్మకం వచ్చింది అంటే ఆఫ్టర్ స్టడీయింగ్ 4.5 ఇయర్స్ అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ప్రాక్టీసింగ్ రియల్లీ ప్రాక్టీసింగ్ చేస్తే నమ్మకం వచ్చి అప్పటి నుండి ఐ స్టార్టెడ్ హోమ్ ప్రాక్టీస్ సాటర్డే సండే ఎందుకంటే అందరూ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఆల్ ఎడ్యుకేటెడ్ ఉండే ఎంప్లాయీస్ ఉండే సాటర్డే సండే అందుకే హెవీ రష్ అన్నట్టు ఇక మార్నింగ్ 8 నుంచి రాత్రి వరకు ఆ టైం తీసుకొని కేస్ స్టడీ చేసుకొని ఐ యూస్ టు గో టు ద కెంట్రీ పట్టరీ చేసుకొని డ్రగ్ సెలెక్షన్ కూడా చేసుకుంటుంది దానికోసం 2 డేస్ టైం పట్టేది అట్లా హౌ దాట్ హోమపతి అంటే కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ ఎందుకంటే దో ఇట్ ఈస్ స్టార్టెడ్ దో డాక్టర్ ఫెడరిక్ హానిమాన్ గారు దో ఈజ్ అలోపతి లైక్ పాలు కృష్ణచోర్ లాగా అలోపతి ప్రాక్టీస్ చేసి హోమపతికి వచ్చాడు హానిమాన్ గారు కూడా ఇప్పుడు మన హానిమాన్ గారు మన పాలు కృష్ణచోర్ గారు కనుక ఆ స్పిరిట్లోంచి ఇరే వచ్చిన తర్వాత సిస్టమ్ మీద ఇంకా ఎఫెక్షన్ పెరగటం నేను ఎంపీ అయిన తర్వాత బీడ్లో మరి ఔరంగాబాద్ మహారాష్ట్ర ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్లో ఎండీ చదివాను మొత్తం సెల్ స్విచ్ ఆఫ్ చేసుకొని 15 రోజులు ఆఫ్ చేసుకొని ఎండీ చదివాను వన్ అంటే పాస్ కాను కాపు కొట్టకుండా పాస్ అయ్యాను అంటే కాదు నడవనుకోండి అట్లా ఎండీ చదివాను అంటే సిస్టమ్ మీద ఎఫెక్షన్ తోటి చదివాను కనుక రామేశ్వరరావు గారు చెప్పాలి ఒకటి దో ఈజే మాతో చదివినప్పటికి కూడా ఈ ఎంటర్డ్ ఇన్ ది అదర్ ఫీల్డ్ బిజినెస్ చేసేసుకొని ఇప్పుడు మహాసిమెంట్ కానీ అదేంటో ఈజ్ ఏ బిల్డర్ కానీ ఏదన్నా కూడా మీకు చూశారు ది కంపెనీ బిట్వీన్ అదర్ బిల్డింగ్స్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ అండ్ రామేశ్వర మై హోమ్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ కనుక ఆయనే ఈరోజు అంటే అవసరమైతే ఇదే అమౌంట్ దాంట్లో స్పెండ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు బిజినెస్ లోపల ఇప్పుడు మనం చూస్తున్నాం అంబానీ కానీ అదాని కానీ చాలామంది సో కాల్డ్ బిజినెస్ పీపుల్ ఇదే రివాల్వింగ్ చేస్తారు అమౌంట్ ఎవరైనా సరే ఇప్పుడు నేను కూడా బిజినెస్ అయితే నేను ఐ డోంట్ నాకు స్టార్ట్ చేయకపోతుండే హోమపతి నేను అంటే నాకు ఇంకా అదే అల్లపతి స్టార్ట్ చేస్తే ఒక మేనేజ్మెంట్ కోట అనేది 1 కోటి రూపాయలు నడుస్తుంది ఇప్పుడు 1-10 కోట్ రూపాయలు మేనేజ్మెంట్ కోట మీరు చూసిండవచ్చు గవర్నమెంట్ కోట పొంగ మేనేజ్మెంట్ కోట నాట్ లెస్ దెన్ 1 కోటి ఆల్ మన తెలంగాణలో కానీ ఆంధ్రాలో కానీ అన్ని చోట్ల కూడా 1-10 కోట్లు ఎవరు తక్కువ తీసుకుంటలేరు మీరు రికమెండ్ చేస్తే అంటే ముందే మీరు చెప్తారు కదా వేణుగోపాల్ గారు చెప్తే వాడు ముందే 1 కోటి ఇచ్చేవారు 1-10 లక్షలు అంటాడు మేము చెప్తే 10 లక్షలు తక్కువ చేస్తాడు మాకు సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్ మీకు సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్ అదే అటువంటి బిజినెస్ నుంచి తను చదివిన స్టడీసు మరి స్వామిగారి ఆలోచన విధానం ఎందుకంటే స్వామిగారు నేచురల్గా ఈరోజు బిఫోర్ కమింగ్ టు దిస్ మీటింగ్ ఈ ఇంటరాక్టెడ్ విత్ అవర్ ఇజ్రాయలీ ఎల్డర్ అండ్ ఆల్సో గుప్తాజీ ఈజ్ లైక్ ఎన్సైక్లోపీడియా ఐ టెలింగ్ ద మెడిసిన్స్ అంటే మనం మీరు ఇప్పుడు చెప్తున్నారు కానీ స్వామిగారు ఎప్పుడు అనుభవం మెడిసిన్ చెప్తుంటే అరే యూఆర్ రిమెంబరింగ్ ఆల్ ది హోమపతి మెడిసిన్స్ అని చెప్పి మన కురాణ సాబు గారు చెప్తున్నారు మీరు మాకనే ఎక్కువ హోమపతి మెడిసిన్ గురించి మాట్లాడుతుందని చెప్పేసి లైక్ ఇస్ ఎన్సైక్లోపీడియా. కనుక స్వామిగారి ఆశీస్సు తోటి రామేశ్వరరావు గారు మరొక హోమియో కళాశాల స్టార్ట్ చేసి నియర్లీ స్పెండ్ సోఫా నాకు తెలిసిన వరకైతే 100 కోట్ల రూపాయలు ఖర్చు పెట్టి 3 సంవత్సరాలు గుడ్ హాస్టల్, బాయ్స్ హాస్టల్, గర్ల్స్ హాస్టల్, మళ్ళీ తర్వాత నేచురల్ ఫుడ్, ఇవన్నీ కూడా మేము చదివినప్పుడు ఇక్కడ ప్రశాంత్ గారు తెలుసు, మేము చదివినప్పుడు రామేశ్వరం మీద ఉన్నప్పుడు 2 రూములు ఉండేది మా కళాశాల, జేసీల కళాశాల. షిఫ్టింగ్ సిస్టమ్ అన్నట్టు 8 to 2, 2 to 8 థియేటర్ సౌండ్లు వచ్చేది, అన్ని సౌండ్లు వచ్చేది, కానీ పాపం వాళ్ళు ప్రశాంత్ వాళ్ళు కష్టపడేది మాకు చదువు చెప్పేది. మేము కూడా ఇక పాస్ కాలకం చదివేది కష్టపడనుకోండి అతి కష్టం మీద. అప్పుడు ఇటువంటి కళాశాలను క్రీడా అడ్మిట్ చేసేది, నేను కూడా అడ్మిట్ అయ్యేది. అంటే ఒక వాతావరణం, ఆధ్యాత్మిక వాతావరణంతో పాటు రియల్గా కళాశాలలో ఇట్లా కళాశాల ఉండాలి అటువంటి వాతావరణంతో ఈ 2 సంవత్సరాల్లో మీకు హెచ్ఓడీలు కానీ ఈరోజు డిపార్ట్మెంట్ హెడ్స్ కానీ నోవేర్ ఇన్ ద కంట్రీ యాజ్ ఐజ్ ఇన్ ద కెపాసిటీ ఆఫ్ ద హెల్త్ అండ్ మెడికల్లో చైర్మన్గా నేను ఐ థింక్ ఐ విజిటెడ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఆల్ ద కంట్రీ హోమియోపతి మెడికల్ కళాశాల చూసినా ఆయుర్వేద చూసినా కానీ నోవేర్ సచ్ ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ డెవలప్డ్ విత్ ఇన్ షార్ట్ స్పాన్ 2 ఇయర్స్ లోపల ఎక్కడ డెవలప్మెంట్ కాలేదు. దట్ క్రెడిట్ ఈరోజు స్వామిగారి బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ వల్ల రామేశ్వర గారు మీ అందరికి ఇచ్చారు. మరి మీ అందరు కూడా చదవటం నిజంగా కూడా అదృష్టమే, ఎందుకంటే స్వామిగారి ఆలోచన ఏంటి, రామేశ్వర ఆలోచన మేరకు ఇక్కడ చదివిన ప్రతి ఒక్క హోమియో వైద్యుడు ఇండియాలో నంబర్1 అవుతాడు తప్పకుండా. బికాస్ యూ గాట్ ఆల్ ఫెసిలిటీస్, ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ ఫెసిలిటీస్ అండ్ ప్రెస్టేజియస్ రీసెర్చ్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ వచ్చింది. తర్వాత మన కురాణ సాబ్, మై గుజారీ అనిల్ కురాణ సాబ్కు ఐ థింక్ నో వేర్ దిస్ ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ యూ ఫైన్, ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ అనిల్ కురాణాజీ 2 మోర్ రీసెర్చ్ యూనిట్స్ లైక్ యు నో డయాబెటీస్ కామన్ ఇన్ ఇండియా అండ్ నేషన్ డయాబెటిక్ ట్యూబర్క్లోసిస్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఎయిడ్స్ ఇన్ సదర్న్ పార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇండియా, ఎయిడ్స్ ఈజ్ ప్రివేలింగ్ మోర్ అండ్ మోర్ ఇన్ జయశ్రీ మెడికల్ కాలేజ్. ఐ థింక్ 2 డేస్ దే కెప్ట్ ఫర్ అవుట్ పేషెంట్, నియర్లీ 4 to 5 thousand పీపుల్ ఆర్ కమింగ్ టు టేక్ ద మెడిసిన్ ఫ్రమ్ జయశ్రీ హోమియో కళాశాల. నియర్లీ క్రిటికల్ హార్ట్ డేస్ అని చెప్పి మెడిసిన్ ఇచ్చడం వల్ల 4000 పేషెంట్లు ఉంటారు. మీరు ఎట్లా పోయినప్పుడు చూడండి, హాలిడే ఉన్నప్పుడు సచ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ హెచ్ఐవి ఆల్సో ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ కురానాజీ ఆ గుజారీషే యా పూరా ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చరే నో వేర్ ఇన్ ద కంట్రీ దిస్ ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ ఇస్ దేర్. వీ రిక్వెస్ట్ యూ ప్రొవైడ్ దిస్ 3 రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్స్ ఇన్ ద జిమ్స్ కాలేజ్, వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ యూ రిక్వైర్ అండ్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఎడ్యుకేటర్స్ ఆల్ ద కోఆపరేటివ్ ఆకు మాలమా బోలే పూరా ఆధ్యాత్మిక కాలేజ్ వాతావరణ ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చరే ల్యాండే ఆర్ ఉస్కో పూరా మిల్కే స్వామి కా ఆశీస్ ఆర్ అమర్ రామేశ్వరరావు కా హాత్ ఐ స్కోపర్ ఉస్రీ ఏమై కురాణ గుజారీస్ ట్యూబర్ కోసిస్ డయాబెటీస్ హెచ్ఐవీ ఫ్రీ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్ మే కైసోబియానా బోలే నా విషయ బోలే ఆ పద్మశ్రీ బోల్తే ఆ పూరా బోలే. దీంతోపాటు మరి మీరు చదువుకున్నారు కూడా దీంట్లోనే మీరు పీజీ కళాశాల వస్తుంది, పీజీ చేయాలి మీరు, రీసెర్చ్ వస్తుంది. తర్వాత ఆఫ్టర్ కమింగ్ టు ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్, ఆఫ్టర్ కమింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ స్వామి గారు ఆశీస్సు ఏంటంటే ఇక్కడ జిమ్స్ అయిన ప్రతి ఒక్క వైద్య విద్యార్థి జిమ్స్ ద్వారానే తెలంగాణలో దాదాపు రామేశ్వరరావు గారు ఆలోచన మేరకు 100 సెంటర్లు పెట్టేసి మన జిమ్స్ స్టూడెంట్ అక్కడ డాక్టర్గా ఉంటాడని చెప్పేసి కూడా ఈ సందర్భంగా తెలియజేస్తున్నా. అదేవిధంగా రామేశ్వర ఆలోచన మేరకు మన మందులు మనకు జిమ్స్లో కూడా త్వరలో ఫార్మసీ వింగ్ కూడా ఈరోజు సీసీఆర్సి సహాయక వల్ల మనం స్టార్ట్ చేసుకోబోతున్నామని చెప్పి సందర్భంగా తెలియజేస్తూ మరి మళ్ళీ ఒకసారి మీరు పక్క చూపులు చూడకండి, స్టేట్ చూడండి, దయచేసి హోమియో వైద్య విధానాన్ని పాటించండి. మీ ఫాదర్స్ మ్యారేజ్ చేసినా కూడా ప్రాక్టీస్ బంద్ కాకుండా అవసరం మీ హస్బెండ్ కొట్లాడండి, మేము కౌన్సిలింగ్ ఇస్తాం, హోమియో కంటిన్యూ చేయండి అని చెప్పి సందర్భంగా తెలియజేస్తూ మరొకసారి అవకాశం ఇచ్చిన స్వామి గారికి ధన్యవాదాలు సెలవు తీసుకుంటాం. జై హింద్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్. మే ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఆర్ చైర్మన్ డాక్టర్ జూపల్లి రామేశ్వరరావు సార్.
జై శ్రీమన్నారాయణ. పూజ్య స్వామీజీ, ఆల్ డిగ్నిటరీస్ ఆన్ ద డయాస్ అండ్ జిమ్స్ ఫ్యాకల్టీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ హాస్పిటల్ స్టాఫ్ అండ్ మై డియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్, టుడే ఈజ్ వెరీ గ్రేట్ డే ఫర్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్. నో విత్ ఇన్ 3 ఇయర్స్ this institute is entered into the research. I'm thankful to CCH for choosing our institute for the research. With the blessing of Swamiji, I will assure you all, we put all our heart and soul into this. We'll make a big global center. As Dr. Venugopalachari told, is my classmate, he was ex-central minister also. See this, we bring all the research scholars in the world together, all intellectuals, and this institute will coordinate with all different faculties, scientists, and with nanotechnology experts, because we all know this is the best system in the world, in the health hazards. But we should know, people wants a lot of proofs and also some standard protocols. Therefore, with the blessing of Swamiji, our guide, Dr. Krishna Chaudhary Garu, Dr. Naveen, Dr. Rita, and with all faculty members are working extremely good. I request all the children also, I really thank all the children also participating very enthusiastically, because this makes more confidence in your future endeavor. Therefore, please associate our Dr. Prashant sir. We are so happy after so many years. He's our teacher. We could see sir to associate with us. He's got excellent knowledge. Therefore, future to come, we'll get the post-graduation. A big research center we'll establish here in a continuous basis. And also, the Swamiji blessings, under the leadership of Swamiji, we would like to start the one of the best standards pharmacology, manufacturing of medicines here. And also, we're discussing, with permission of Swamiji, and advanced allopathic hospitals also. We requested already, they show the hospitals, they have three hospitals, they are building another big hospital, 1,000-bedded hospital, with all advanced technology. We also already tied up with them to establish our centers in their hospitals. As Dr. Chari told, JIMS should establish with our own students in the future to come. At least a minimum 100 centers we have been targeting. Therefore, you have a bright future and also you have a lot of responsibility on your shoulder. See, Swamiji is so busy, he'll be moving all over the world. But this homeopathy is so close to his heart. It is our job to do our best. We should work very hard. We should bring this system top of the world. We all know, we all convinced, this is a very safe system. This is the only advanced scientific system in medical field. Simply got infected, you can't kill the bacteria. You should make our body to fight it out. Therefore, our philosophy, if you understand our Organon application of methodology, it is the real scientific system. Therefore, I request all the students, work hard. It is good to your parents and yourself, good to the nation, good to all humanity. We are yet to provide all the infrastructure, not only infrastructure, guidance, bringing all the talent in the world like Dr. Guptaji and doctor from Israel. They are excited. They would like to share their experience with you. They would like to work with you. Like that, the blessing of Swamiji will bring all the talented pool to this institution and will make a permanent research foundation here. You're all lucky. I only request you utilize this opportunity, dedicate yourself. Every person has a purpose coming to this world. God is chosen all of you. Be dedicated with the system and serve the nation and needy people. Thank you one and all. Jai Sri Mandara.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. May I request our principal, Dr. K. Raghuram Chandra, sir, to conclude this program with his vote of thanks.
Jai Sriman Narayan. Very good evening. Respected dignitaries on the dais, my dear staff and students, the times have changed. We have reached to the day for this institute and the history is rewritten. We have taken our journey. We have not yet finished. We are under fives only. Infancy is done, but childhood is on. Our students are just appearing at third year. All this is possible. I bow to His Holiness Sri 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 Tridandi Ramanuja Chinna Jeeyar Swamiji. Sir, this is all possible with your Sankalpa Siddhi, what we call that as. All that has trickled down, hats off to Master Hanuman. May his teachings bless us. Now this day is
celebrated here by all our students in the presence of, with the blessings of all the senior Padma Shri
also. Now this is an inspiration which we are further looking forward for few many other research projects. I thank His Holiness Sriman Narayana Chinna Jeeyar Swamiji that Swamiji, you have inaugurated the pediatric research project which is unique in the history of this institute. I once again compliment Rita Ji for achieving this within a short span. I thank our beloved young old senior most mentor Sri Pavaluri Krishna Chaudhary Garu, Dr. Krishna Chaudhary Garu. I am sorry, extremely sorry. Sir, you have been advising us, guiding us, and we have been learning organon of medicine, the Gita, what we call that as the Holy Bible, anything of what we call that as, for a homeopathic practitioner, physician. I am extremely happy today you have blessed us, our children, because of that, this progress. I am extremely thankful to Dr. Jupalli Rameshwar Rao Garu, my home. Sir, you have given this platform. This is definitely my home only, no doubt about it. And our children are doing perfectly good. It is not that I am praising my own self or my children. They are blessed by senior teachers only. I am extremely happy that you have provided us this platform. Thank you, sir. I thank Dr. Samudrala Venugopalachari, sir, who has been behind us, a political support, definitely doctor, homeopathic doctor only. All we are homeopathic doctors only. Sir, you have extended us your support. You could find out time to guide us, to bless our children. Definitely our student must have missed MBBS seat, but yet we a destiny is reached. I definitely promise that our children will be flourishing. I thank Dr. Menachem Oberbaum, sir, Director CICM, Jerusalem, Israel. We are extremely happy to find you on this second occasion, sir. You have guided us and you have offered us this pilot study, the pediatric study, what we are going ahead with. I am happy, really happy. I thank Dr. Anil Khurana, sir, Deputy Director General, sir, CCRH. You have recognized us. Earlier, you have visited this institute and you have extended your support. We started with HPT, homeopathic pathogenetic trials at our center, and you are convinced. I am extremely happy that this institute finished first of that in short span. Then we are also blessed with second such project, HPT again second quota, and then now the MOU with Israel has been signed by our Honorable Prime Minister, sir. And that you have graced us to this institute, I am extremely happy. I am thankful for this, our institution is recognized. I thank Dr. Anupriya Chaudhary, Madam, the research officer, who has been in association with this institute, with this research project. I am happy that you are supporting all the way. You are in association with Dr. Rita Ji, the medical superintendent. Thank you, Madam. I am extremely happy to find Padma Shri Dr. Professor V.K. Gupta Ji, Chairman, Scientific Advisory Committee, Central Council for Research in Homeopathy, ex-principal, Nehru Homeopathic Medical College, New Delhi. Sir, definitely may it be a first visit, but you have graced the occasion, you have blessed our children. I am extremely happy that our students definitely got motivated and they also would like to become Padma Shri, many other. So we look forward. Thank you, sir. Yes. Yes, Padma Bhushan as well. Thank you so much. We should find. So homeopathic practitioners recognized with such awards, rather exceptional, we were definitely blessed, sir. Thank you so much. Then Dr. Hima Bindu, Madam, I thank for your association with this project. You have been continuously in touch with Dr. Rita Ji, Dr. Anupriya, Madam, and you are extending your support for this project. I am thank you once again. I thank to the parents who are not actually present in this occasion, but definitely they are the material, clinical material they have started with this. We cannot ignore thanking them, the 11 infants, neonates, and their parents. I am extremely happy that they are counseled perfectly well and they have shown faith in us and they have associated with us for a period of 1.5 years is not a small thing. Definitely that has to be acknowledged. I am extremely happy we started with 11. Definitely we progress further. I am extremely thankful to those parents. Then I thank to my teacher, Dr. Nanduri Shiva Prashant sir, chairperson IEC. Now today we recognize him as member of this family, my home, once again, JIMS family. So sir was our teacher, my teacher. He taught me Organon of Medicine, once again the same Gita which we are quoting. Sir, you are supporting this institute again. Teacher, student is having susceptibility and he invited teacher. So definitely I am extremely happy, sir, with a short notice you could make it possible and you are guiding us. Thank you, sir. I thank Rajgopal ji, I don't know exactly, press and media. Yes, sir, they have been doing good. Rajgopal ji, Anil and Rachna madam, I am extremely happy to find the coordination with them. I am also thankful to all our directors team. Kote sir, Rita madam, Naveen sir, and all my staff who helped me, and I am extremely happy to find all our students actively participating in research projects. I thank to students as well. I thank to all the printing media, journalists and technical support, which electronic media. So I thank one and all who has contributed to this grand success in the history of JIMS Homeopathic Medical College and Hospital. I thank one and all, and Jai Hind, Jai Sri Manna.
Let us all stand for the national anthem of both India and Israel.